start a discussion on a very important topic for the advanced taxation exam, that is trading losses. Now, first of all, when we calculate the tax adjusted trading profit, sometime it happens that instead of a profit, we came across a value that is a loss. For example, suppose in the tax year 2021, we got a figure of tax adjusted trading loss. Suppose 50,000. Now, question is, when there is a profit, you have to pay tax on that profit. But when there is loss, then you can get a relief that is called loss relief. So first of all, in case of any trading loss, you need to know that what are the options available for a business. Now, for the time being, we are discussing about a sole trader as well as a partnership. So whatever is the rule of sole trader are applicable on partnership as well. So first of all, let's classify our business into three stages. It might be an ongoing business, it might be an opening year business, and it might be a closing year business. So with respect to the type of the business, the situation of the business, there are various different loss relief methods are available. So first of all, what are the possible loss relief methods for any business? One method, which is common to all, is called the carry forward method. Second one is you can offset your loss against current year income, and that is called total income approach. Another option available is called the carry back method, and that is again available against the total income. These three methods are standard method for any business, for any type of situation, whether the business is a new one, whether the business is whatever is the stage. And there are three more methods available. One is called the special opening year loss relief method. Another is terminal loss relief method. And the last one is called incorporation relief. As there are various methods available, so we need to know that in what situation forward is beneficial, in what situation current year is beneficial, how you can allocate loss against the special opening year loss relief. So we'll deal with each and everything one by one. So before moving to the methods, let's identify that we have an ongoing business. Ongoing business means the business is already started and now it's having loss in current year. Say suppose in 2021, there is a trading loss. So for an ongoing business, what options we have available? So we have to explore that what options are available and how you can utilize that option. So one option is you can offset this current year loss with current year total income. Means trading loss can be offset against current year total income, means against interest income, dividend income, property income, whatever is the type of income available. And after offsetting with the current year total income, if there is any further loss left, so now you have choice. What you can do then, you can either carry it forward against what? Against future trading profit. One option is after offsetting with current year total income, then use the carry forward option. Another option which is available after current year is to offset your trading loss against chargeable gain. This is something very special treatment. So I'll discuss it later on, how you can utilize trading loss with chargeable gain. And after offsetting with current year total income, then chargeable gain, what is the option left? You can use carry forward. It means carry forward option is available for every business and it can be utilized after offsetting with other type of loss relief. Now, you have to see in the question that which one is the beneficial way. And if examiner says that do not use carry forward, then you have to tell the examiner the alternate ways available and you have to calculate, you have to identify tax savings accordingly. We will discuss the past paper question as well. Now, one option that a business can also utilize is, suppose again, in 2021, suppose we have a tax adjusted trading loss of suppose 50,000. Now we have option available that we can use it against current year total income. We can also offset it with last year total income. And we can do this in any order. Means first utilize against current year and then carry back, or first utilize against carry back and then utilize the current year. But there is a restriction in carry back and there is only 12 month carry back option available. It means if you want to utilize your current year loss against the previous year, you just go back up to 12 month, not more than that. And if utilizing the current year loss with current year profit and then the carry back, if further loss is available, then there is only one option left and that is called the carry forward option available. So in this way, you have to explore what options are available and how you can utilize all these options. Now let's see what other options we have available as per the situation, as per the availability. So let me summarize this discussion into by using this diagram. I will answer your question. Just wait for that. Let me just discuss a few more things, then I will clarify you. But up till now, I have discussed that if you want to utilize the carry back option, so it is only 12 months availability because we are talking about the ongoing business. We are not talking about right now for the opening year business or the closing year business. So I'm just talking about the ongoing business. Now see, what I told you is if there is a loss available in the ongoing years, for example, the business is already in the ongoing stage. So you have an optional claim. What is the optional claim? You have optional claim, that is, you can offset against total income of the current year. Then you have another option available, that is against chargeable gain. Now both is optional. It means you have a choice. And when you have a choice, you have to use that choice wisely. And after using the relief against total income, you can utilize remaining against carry forward. And after offsetting against chargeable gain, you can utilize against carry forward. But you cannot use chargeable gain option at first. Chargeable gain is only possible after current year. If you are not using current year option, then chargeable gain option is not available. It's subject to the relief against total income. Now, if you want to use against the total income, for example, then we have to see that what options we have available. So, and what is the restriction on current year rules, first of all. So let's talk about the carry forward. If a business want to utilize the carry forward loss relief available, so it is to be offset against future trading profit, not against total income. You cannot offset against total income. You have to offset your current year trading loss with the next year trading profit of the same trade. Trade must be same. And partial offset is not allowed. What it means? It means that if you have an option to offset all of your loss in the next year, you cannot use the partial option available. So you have to utilize the full option available. There is no time restriction. You can utilize this loss for indefinite period. There is no time restriction availability. And it's an automatic relief. What it means? It means if you are not applying for any other loss relief method, then tax authority will apply the carry forward loss relief method. Now, sometime it happens that if you have any current year loss and you think that the business is going to have more losses in future, then carry forward option is not available. Or it might be possible that in future you want to discontinue your business. So if you want to utilize your losses as early as possible, then carry forward is not a good option. In that case, what you have to utilize, you have to use either current year and carry back, or first carry back and current year. Now, if you want to use the carry back method, I told you there is a restriction that you can go back up to 12 months, not more than that. And in both case, there is a common practice, there's a common restriction that partial offset is not allowed. You have to utilize your loss in full. And against total income, you have to utilize your loss against total income, not against the trading profit, against the total income. You have to also consider the availability of personal allowance in your current year as well as in your in the previous year. Because if you are utilizing your loss, then it is possible that you might lost your personal allowance benefit. So you have to sacrifice your personal allowance in case of current year and in case of carryback. So you have to be careful that whether you want to utilize your personal allowance or whether you want to utilize the loss relief. Like for example, suppose in 2021, we have trading loss of suppose 20,000. And we have property income in the same year that is available to 12,000. Now, if I'm trying to offset my trading loss with property income in the current year, then what would happen? I will write this. In the current year, I have property income that is 12,000. utilize your loss current year against that property income, it means after the loss relief, your net income is zero. And how much loss you have utilized? Out of 20,000, you have utilized 12,000 against property income. So your unrelieved loss remaining is 8,000. But what would happen? Where is your personal allowance benefit? Now there is no net income to be offset against that personal allowance. So in that case, your personal allowance will be vested. So there is no taxable income. It means if you want to opt for the current year offsetting, you have to be careful that whether you want to offset this against current year or whether current year is not a good option. Now, in this case, current year offsetting is not a good option. Why? Because let's see, we have property income of 12,000 and we have personal allowance of 12,500. So my property income is already offsetted with my personal allowance. So there is no need to use the current year loss relief. So the best option is this one. Instead of using the current year loss relief, I have to use my property income against personal allowance. And what about the 20,000 trading loss? Then I have to identify alternate ways. For this trading loss, I have to identify other options. It might be carry back, it might be forward. So whenever you are trying to utilize the relief method, you have to consider the availability of personal allowance as well. Now, at this time, if you want to ask any question, one student is asking that, isn't carry back is for 36 months? No. In case of an ongoing business, there is only 12-month carryback rule available, but this 36-month is also available, but with some special cases, not with the ongoing business. For an ongoing business, we have three options available. One is the current year, other is the carryback 12-month, and the carry forward option available. Nothing else. Chargeable gain option is exceptional, which I will discuss if I'll get time today. I'll discuss at the end because I don't want to mix it up with the chargeable gain, because chargeable gain is entirely a separate topic. So don't mix until and unless you know the rules of chargeable gain. Do not mix trading losses with chargeable gain. Otherwise, you people will be confused. Now, same three options are available for an ongoing partnership. Partnership is again an important topic, and examiners usually ask a question on partnership sometimes. So ongoing partnership means a running partnership. There are three options available for partners. One is current year loss relief, same. We have carry forward option available, and we have carry back option available. So all three possible methods, which is available for an individual business, are available for an ongoing partnership as well, with same condition and same rules and regulation, nothing different. So if examiner is putting a question of partnership instead of the sole trader, don't worry about that. You have to apply the same rule. Now, one important thing. If you want to use the current year as well as the carry back, so I already told you that partial offsetting is not allowed. It means that if there is a potential to offset loss, then you have to utilize that potential 100%. but there is a concept called restriction on loss relief against current year and carry back. So we have to follow that restriction as well. And that is called maximum deduction against total income. What it called? It called maximum deduction against total income. Now let's discuss the restriction. Maximum deduction against total income. In advanced taxation exam, remember one thing. Theoretical part are also very important. And sometime examiner usually asks the theory. Examiner says that just explain, no need for any calculation. So if you know the rules properly, if you memorize the rules, then just you have to write the rules. But if examiner says that explain with some calculation, then it might be possible that you are not able to calculate it properly. But for theoretical part, you'll always get the correct marks if you know the rules. So you should follow the rules in such a way that for each and every tax issue, your rules should be very much clear that what is the available rule. Now, when I have to apply this maximum deduction rule against what? When I'm using total income option. And this is, it means that this restriction is applicable against both current year and carry back method. Nothing else, just two methods. So whenever you are using current year method or carry back method, you have to apply this maximum deduction rule. What is this maximum? It is called a cap. Means you cannot utilize more than the maximum deduction. So how you can find out this maximum deduction? There is a formula which says that the deduction, maximum deduction is greater of. You have to identify two values, greater of. One is a fixed value, no need to identify, 50,000 is fixed. Another is 25% of adjusted total income. So in order to identify the cap, you have to identify A, 50,000, which is given, which is fixed, and B, 25% of adjusted total income. Suppose my adjusted total income is, suppose it's 100,000 for a given tax year. Now, what is the cap availability for current year? It's A, 50,000, which is fixed, B, 25% of 100,000, which is 25,000. Now, what I have to choose? I have to choose the greater of, and that greater of is 50,000. Now, what it means? It means in current year, you cannot offset your loss more than 50,000. This is a cap. You cannot use more than 50,000. So this cap is applicable for current year as well as for the carry back. Now, in this formula, that is greater of 50,000 and 25% of adjusted total income. Now, what is adjusted total income? If you have already gone through my income tax computation, the basic one, the pro forma of income tax, so you came across few terminologies such as total income, adjusted net income, taxable income, but this is a different terminology, which is called adjusted total income, that is ATI. So you need to know the formula for ATI. And the formula for your advanced taxation syllabus for ATI is usually The original formula, let me share the formula. This is the original formula. For adjusted total income, this is the original formula. But for advanced taxation, ignore this. Ignore this one. So what would be the formula then? Identify total income and deduct from the total income just one item. That is called gross personal pension contribution. And if there is no personal pension contribution, then your total income will be adjusted total income. And for PPC, you have to refer my personal allowance calculation discussion in the first lecture. There I use this PPC concept that if net PPC is given, how you can gross it up. Let me remind you again, then if you have given net PPC, what do you have to do? Divide this by 0.8 and you will get a figure of gross PPC. There is a separate concept. There is a separate topic in our syllabus that is called pension contribution. And mind you, pension is one of the most favorite topic of examiner. Usually examiner asks in the section B, either pension, tax losses, basis period with change of accounting date, and sometimes employment share option scheme. These 5 to 6 topics are examiner's favorite. So examiner rotate from one diet to another diet, sometimes pension, sometimes like another thing. For example, let me show you one of the past paper question so that you can see a very good question. The key is for advanced taxation is memorize the rule and practice the relevant exam question. The maximum you can practice, the maximum you can memorize the rules and get the marks. Now see, this is a past paper question, a very, very important question, Jessica. And see, the examiner has mixed various topics. In the first part, examiner says that explain with supporting calculations. Now mark, this is the usual pattern. Explain the tax rule and also do some minor calculation. Now, this is related with redundancy. And this redundancy means it is a topic which is covered under employment income, only 5 months. So if you know the redundancy rule well, so you can easily get 2 or 3 marks for theory. And this is the relevant paragraph. So see the requirement. And we have to jump towards the relevant paragraph. You have to see what redundancy payment has been given there. And we have to connect with the theory that what is statutory redundancy payment rule, what is ex gratia payment rule. And then you can connect with this example. So you can get 3, 2, 4 marks easily. The next one is advise Jessica of the option available to relieve her share of partnership loss. Now, as I was talking earlier, that sometimes examiner asks sole trader losses, sometimes the same partnership losses, right? On the assumption that she does not wish to carry any of the loss forward, just 3 months. Advice, it means no calculation available. You have to just show the options available. So it means if forward option is not there, so what other options are available? You have to identify and you have to write it down. But the second part is complicated, where examiner says that if you are using any option in B part one, you have to find out the tax saving, which is one of the difficult thing in each your identified option. You have to save your tax. You have to identify how much tax has been saved and you have to calculate the overall income tax saving, which is worth 7 marks. That means calculation. And in the last part, examiner has asked about the pension contribution, which is a separate topic, 5 marks. So in just one question, there are 3 different topics. One is employment income, a redundancy issue. The other one is the loss relief method, worth 10 marks. And the third one is a personal pension contribution part question. It means 100% syllabus coverage is always advisable so that you will not miss any of the part of the examiner. And you have to attempt the maximum paper in the exam as well in order to get the 50 marks available. Now, just connect our discussion again. So whenever I have to use the current year option or the carry back option, I have to see this rule as well. I have to keep in mind this rule as well, that whether I am allowed to offset this or not. Now, suppose, see, let me give you an example. So 2021 is the current year. We have calculated the tax adjusted profit, and this turns out to be 80,000, a loss. And we have, suppose, employment income in the same year, and that employment income is, suppose, 1,60,000. Now, use current year relief, identify how much loss can be utilized, and also identify the unrelieved loss that either to be carry back or carry forward. Now see, I have tax adjusted loss 80,000. I have employment income 1,60,000. So you can see, if a student is having no idea about the cap rule, then a student will say that you can utilize the whole 80,000 against employment income. But as it is a current year case, so I have to identify first of all my cap. And what is that cap? Is greater of a fixed value, that is 50,000, and B, 25% of adjusted total income. In this example, there is only one income, and that is employment income. So my adjusted total income is also 160. 160 into 0.25, that is, I guess it's 40,000. Correct me if I'm wrong. So what is the greater of? So the cap is higher of, that is 50,000. It means you cannot go beyond 50,000 in current year, not less than 50,000, not more than 50,000. So let's utilize. Loss is 80,000. Potential is 160,000, but my tax rule says that how much you can offset? Just only 50,000. So my employment income is 1,60,000, and loss relief in the current year is only 50,000, just due to that cap. So remaining is my net income for the current year. Total loss was 80,000, utilized in current year 50,000. How much is the remaining loss? 30,000. And that is called unrelieved loss. Now look for other options. What other options available for an ongoing business? So you can advise either to carry back, or you can advise, you can carry forward, or you can give an advice that you can offset against chargeable gain. Any question? Up till now, if you have any issue, the detailed topic, the detailed lectures are available in my pre-recorded lectures of each and every topic. So the live class purpose is to, guys, just to engage you all in the live discussion, so that if you can ask any question, I will answer that question. And the more in the later stages, our focus will be on past paper practice from the coming weeks. Now, so up till now, the discussion was based on an ongoing business, whether that was a sole trader business or a partnership business. And there are three options available. One is carry forward against the future profit. Next is current year against the total income, having a cap, against carry back against the total income, having a cap. And there is a 12-month restriction. Now let's talk about a special loss relief method. Again, this is a very important concept, which is called special opening loss relief. Now, for which entity this special opening loss year method is available? It's not available for every entity. It's not available for an ongoing business. It's not available for an ongoing partnership. In order to use that, first of all, there must be a business which is in the commencement age. Business that is in commencement age. So these are the rules. Let's focus on the rule. This special opening year loss relief, first of all, is to be offset against total income. But this is an optional claim, not mandatory. And what it means, opening. Opening means it is for the first 4 year tax year of trading loss. Means you have started your business in 2021, 2022, 2023, 2024. These are the first 4 years. If any new business get a loss in any of the first 4 years, then the relief method is available, that is called special opening year relief method. Now, suppose, for example, this 2021 is my first year and I have a loss of 10,000. So as per the normal method, that is the current year, that is the carry back and forward, all three methods are available. An extra relief is available. And what is that extra relief? And that is called a special opening year loss relief. Now, what is why it's special? See, if claimed against, it claimed against total income in three tax year before tax year of loss on a first in, first out basis, earlier year first. It means there is a special category that you can use carry back method for such business and extended carry back. The usual carry back is 12 months and the extended carry back is 36 months, which is for a special opening year loss relief only, not for the normal business. What is first in, first out? So if there is a loss in 2021, you have to offset first against 17-18, then against 18-19, and if anything left over, then against 19-20, in the order that is called first in, first out. And partial offsetting is not allowed, must set off maximum amount possible. So for a new business, if there is any type of income available in the previous year, in the previous 3 years, so that you have an opportunity that you can get the loss relief from the carry back. And if you are using carry back, you will get a refund. So if you are getting any refund, that is cash flow, that is inflow, and that is beneficial for organization having cash flow shortage. So whenever you want to advise any carry back method, always remember that this is useful for those business having cash flow shortage. If any business is cash rich, then carry back method is not appropriate for such business. Then alternate methods can be utilized. As partial offsetting is not allowed, so if you are opting for the carry back method, therefore, chances are that the previous year personal allowances will be vested. So you have to remember the rule. this is the complete picture, this is the complete rule of a special opening year loss relief. But there is a hurdle in special opening year loss relief method, and that hurdle is very technical. And what is that? Before identifying the loss relief, you have to identify the basis period for a new business. In the previous live discussion, I was discussing about if there is a new business. So how we can identify a basis period for a new business? And that was the case of profit. So for a new business, that is commencement of business, and in the first year, there is a loss. So how we can identify the basis period for a loss-making business? Let's take an example. For example, Mr. A started a business on 1st October 20. Accounting year is trying to make an accounting year of 30th September 21 and incurred a loss of 42,000 in the first year. In the next accounting year, that is 30th September 22, there is a profit. Now, before finding out the relief against 42,000, that what method you want to opt? And in the previous year, we have employment income. That is in 17-18, it's 5,000. In 18-19, it's 8,000. And in 19-20, it's 20,000. So Mr. A started a business on 1st October 20, and in the first year there is a loss. Its accounting year is 30th September 21. That means first accounting year is of 12 months, and subsequently he's getting some profit. But previously he was an employee and he was earning an employment income of 5,000, then 8,000 and 20,000. So first of all, what we have to do, we have to identify the relevant basis period, because we have to identify his first business tax year. What is the business tax year? So we have to identify the relevant basis period. So what is the rule of basis period for a commencement business? For year one, we'll start from the commencement date. What is the commencement date? And we'll pay tax up to 5th April, if there is anyone. So my commencement date was 1st October 20. So in this way, it's 1st October 20 and 5th April 21. How much is the amount? The 12 month loss is 42,000. So I'll opt October, November, December, Jan, Feb, March. That means how much loss I have to utilize. The relevant loss for the tax year 2021 is 21,000. Now follow the commencement rule again. In the next year, that is 2022, I have to start again from what? The commencement date. Commencement to following 12 months. Now, see, in the case of profitable business, if you use again the commencement date to 12 months, there is a concept called overlapping of profit. And what we do with overlapping of profit, any idea? If there is any overlapping in the first 2 or 3 years, what do we do with that overlapping profit? I discussed in the last lecture that what you can do with overlapping profit. Overlapping profit means tax paid twice, and you will get relief against overlapping after few years in the cessation period or in the case of change in accounting date. But the tax authority is very smart. In case of losses, they do not allow overlapping of losses. There is no terminology called overlapping of losses. It means the complete loss from 1st October 20 to 30th September 21, my complete loss is 42,000. But as I have utilized or used or 21,000 earlier, so my remaining loss will be 21,000. So there is no duplication of loss relief. When there is a profit, there is a duplication, but when there is a loss, tax authority do not allow you to duplicate your losses. So remember, whenever examiner give you a situation of opening year business and such business is having losses, be careful. First of all, you have to identify the relevant basis period, the relevant profit or loss, and then you have to think about that what is the special opening loss relief available. Now, after identifying the basis period, now this is the first tax year, this is the second tax year. We have loss in the first tax year, we have loss in the second tax year. Now I will opt for the special opening loss relief. So first I will utilize 2021 loss of 21,000 against what? 36 month carry back. Is there any income in previous period? See, there is an employment income, and using first in first out, it means first I have to utilize 17-18, then 18-19, and then 19-20. So I have to utilize this loss of 21,000 against 17-18. How much was the income? Just 5,000. 18-19, it was 8,000. So whatever left, what is the leftover? 13. So it means 8,000 remaining. And I have utilized 8,000 in 19-20. It means all 21,000 being covered using 36 month carry back method. I hope you'll get an idea that how you can identify the basis period and how you can utilize the 36 month rule against the loss. Now, subsequently for 21-22, for 21-22, what do you have to do? For 21-22, there is a loss of 21,000, and the relevant 36 month will start from 18-19, nothing already utilized, 19-20, and 2021. So in 1920, I have employment income of 20,000, of which 8,000 was utilized already. So remaining employment income was 12,000. And here we have no employment income. So it means the 21,000 loss, how much you can offset 18-19 nil? Nothing. 19-20 available 12,000. 20-21 nil. So the unrelieved loss is 9,000. Now you have to look for other methods such as carry forward, and any other possible method. A student finds it very difficult, this topic, both in the F6 level or the advanced taxation level, because the reason is that you have many choices. And when you have choices, then you have to think about each and every choice. But I always suggest my student that you must be very much, confident about the theoretical rules. It's all about theoretical rules. If your calculation is not up to the mark, then mind you, you can still get good marks if you are theoretically correct, if you are sound in your taxation rules. So whatever is the time left for the December exam, what you have to do? Just go through the text, just go through the notes. If you are a regular student, see, we have for each topic, we have the text rules in such forms available. The same rules, which is almost there in the book as well, but bit handy in terms of the PowerPoint slides. So you can use this in order to memorize the maximum rule. And once you will identify the maximum rules, then there are chances that you can get theoretical marks. Any question? Now I'm allowing you people to ask a question. I'm allowing you to speak as well. Now, if anyone want to ask in Urdu or English, whatever medium you want to use, you have option available. Okay. So let's complete something more. So let's talk about another method available, and that is called terminal loss relief. One thing more, in case of partnership, if it's a commencement of partnership, so what we will do, we will apply the basis period rule first, and there is trading loss. Same special opening year loss relief method is applicable. And if there is an ongoing partnership and in that ongoing partnership, someone trying to get a seat, that is admission of a new partner. For example, Mr. A and B was running their partnership business. Now Mr. C wants to join that business. So for Mr. C, this is a case of a commencement of business. So we'll apply the basis period rule for Mr. C. And for other partners, we'll apply the normal rules, that is the ongoing business. So examiner might ask a question with respect to admission of partner, because the admission of partner is a very technical area. Because first of all, you have to identify the relevant basis period, then you have to allocate the loss, and then you have to find out the relevant relief method available. For example, let's focus on this example. Your client Jessica has requested advice in relation to the tax liability arising on a redundancy payment, first issue. The options available for loss of a partnership business, second, and the maximum contribution in the pension scheme. There are three issues usually. Now, who is Jessica? Jessica is a UK resident and UK domicile. She was previously an employee up to 31st March 2021, that is tax year 2021, and she was made redundant. And now she joined a partnership business on 1st July 2021. That is the tax year 21 and 22. Has never made any disposal of for capital gain tax purpose. And now there is a detail of her income. As far as employment income is concerned, Jessica received an annual salary of 1,45,000 each year from the tax year 1890. She also provided with a laptop by the company. So this particular part is with respect to employment income. The next says that there is no other source of income other than employment. But from 2021, she has a rental income of 6,000 each tax year. And now we have redundancy package information, but I'm interested in this, the partnership. Prior to 1st July, there were two partners, I and F. It means Jessica has joined an ongoing partnership business. So for Jessica, we have to apply the commencement rule. So from 1st July, now the sharing ratio is changed. I will get 20%, F will get 40%, and my client will get 40% of loss. And the budgeted tax adjusted trading loss for the partnership is for the year ended March, 1,60,000. Now see, when Jessica has joined the partnership, Jessica has joined the partnership not on 1st April. Jessica has joined this partnership on 1st July. It means for first 3 months, the profit will go to INF 50-50. And for the rest of 9 months, the profit will be split into 20, 40 and 40%. And from the next year onwards, we have a profit of partnership. Now, can you identify what options available for Jessica in the first year? Anyone? It's an opening year for Jessica. Just identify, no calculation. I'm not asking about any calculation. If this is the first year for Jessica, so what loss relief options are available for her? 1, 2, 3, 4, what? Anyone? Any idea? Yes, one option is carry forward, which is available for any business, which is available for any situation. Second is, if there is any current year income, you can utilize current year loss relief. Third one is normal 12-month carry back and a special opening year loss relief against 36 month of the previous 3 year profit available. So it means for Jessica, there are 4 options available. And what about INF? How many options are available? They have 3 options available. Current year, carry back 12 month and carry forward. This 4th option is not available for I and F. This is only available for Jessica. So if Jessica will utilize the 36 carry month option, so we have to go back, we have to calculate the previous year profit, and we have to identify how much tax has been saved while utilizing the. So we have to follow this 2, part 1A, in which I have to advise only. And this says that she does not wishes to carry any of the loss forward. It means you cannot advise forward now. You have to advise the alternate. And in the next part, it says that calculate tax saving if you use the above option in B1. So once you will confident about the loss relief calculation, then you will opt this B part 2. Otherwise, you will not able to attempt this B part 2. B part 1 is very easy. Just to identify and discuss, write in 2 paragraphs that 2 options are available. One is this, other is that. Now let's move to move back to the discussion again. Now, another option available, and that is called terminal loss relief. This is for what type of business? First of all, cessation of business, for closure of business. If you are trying to shut down your business and have losses in last year, then what options available? What normal options available for a terminal, for the cessation of business? No carry forward, because there is no future business. You have current year. You have carry back. How much? These are normal loss relief method. Normal methods, which is available for any business. So if any business is about to be shut down, then there is a possibility that you are not able to utilize your losses. So tax authority allowed you to use another option, that is terminal loss relief, carry back 36 months using last in, first out option. This is a special treatment only available for those business having closure of business. It means this is also applicable for cessation of partnership. If there is a closure of partnership, this is available for those partners as well. And this is also available for a partner who is trying to quit from the partnership. Retirement of a partner. So from an ongoing partnership, if someone is trying to detach from the partnership, then for that particular partner, we'll apply the loss, terminal loss relief option. Now let's see how you can calculate terminal loss. Terminal loss definition is a bit tricky. So how you can identify terminal loss? See, this is the definition of terminal loss. A bit tricky definition that says that terminal loss is the loss of the last 12 months of trading. It means if the last period is of 12 months, then it's very easy to calculate terminal loss. But if the last period is less than 12 months, then you have to combine a period of 12 months in order to calculate terminal loss. Let me give you an example how to calculate this. Suppose, for example, the normal business accounting year end is suppose 30th September. And for the year ended 30th September 2018, we have a profit of 50,000. For the next year, we have a profit of 85,000. And in the subsequent period, we have closed our business for the period ended 30th September 20 and having a loss of 35,000. And there is an overlap profit available from the initial period, and that is worth 5,000. Now calculate terminal loss. Now we have to identify terminal loss. So what is terminal loss? By definition, a terminal loss is the loss of last 12 months. So what is my last 12 month? My last 12 month is from 1st October 19 to 30th September 20. This is my last 12 month. 1st October 19 to 30th September 20. This is my last 12 month. But for the examination purpose, I will use terminal loss like this. See, this is the terminal loss definition. That first of all, you have to use 6th April from 6th April to the cessation date, and then the remaining from 5th April to 12 month. Let's apply this rule here. Now, this is the situation. This is my 12 month. But I have to apply the terminal loss. So first, from 6th April 20 to 30th September 20. How much loss? 6 month loss is 35,000. So this is 35,000 multiplied by 6 divided by 12. And I guess it's 17,500 loss. Now utilized overlap profit. Deduct overlap profit. If you deduct overlap profit, then it's already a minus figure. So if you deduct overlap profit, this becomes total 22,500. Now, how much you have covered? You have covered from 6th April to 30th September. But the terminal loss is of last 12 months. So we have to go back from 5th April, go back 5th April 20, go back 1st October 19, 6 months, 35,000. Into 6 by 12, that is 17,500. And final, my terminal loss is, it's 40,000. A shortcut is, if you have a last period 12 month, not less than that. So a shortcut is you can also do this 12 month loss, that is 35,000, deduct overlap profit 5,000. So total terminal loss is 40,000. But this shortcut is only applicable when the last period is of exactly 12 months. If last period is less than 12 months, then you have to follow the same approach that I have used. You have to create a 12 month period. And this is a bit tricky calculation. So if a business is having losses in the last 12 month of trading, so what option is available? I told you there are various options available, but an option available which is called terminal loss relief. Now you can get a chance to carry back all the available terminal loss and you can utilize it from the previous trading income. From which income you can offset? You can offset from the previous trading income, not against the total profit, trading income. So terminal loss is to be offset against trading profit. Offset against trading profit, 36 month carry back using not the first in first out approach. That is the last in first out approach. For example, the loss here is suppose 21-22. So you have to utilize first against 20-21, then 19-20, and then 18-19. These are the
last in, first out approach. And if there is any unrelieved loss, then that loss will be vested. Lastly, I have discussed four possible methods in this today's discussion. Not yet discussed the chargeable gain option available, but let's discuss the last option available, and that is called the incorporation relief. Now, for incorporation, let's discuss the rule of incorporation and what options is available. Now, sometime it happens that you have closed your business and the business is shut down. And sometimes the reason for closure is because you want to incorporate your unincorporated business. For example, there is a sole trader who want to close his business. Why? What is the reason? Reason is he want to incorporate this business into a company. It means the sole trader business will be seized and there will be a corporation now. And in the case of cessation, there is this loss available. So how that person will get the loss relief? Because his business is suspended now and has been converted into a company. So we'll go for the rules of loss relief available against the corporation income, that whatever income he's driving from the corporation, he will offset the loss of his business against the company's income. But there are conditions, and you have to memorize this condition. It's very important. First condition is, what is first condition? Let me highlight this condition. Condition. Business is transferred to a company. First condition. Next, what you are receiving against this, wholly or mainly for shares, the consideration that you are receiving while incorporating this business as a company is at least 80% must be in the form of shares. If, for example, you are receiving consideration, partly shares and partly other thing, and that is 50%, it means incorporation relief is now not available. So memorize these two conditions, that it must be a company and the consideration must be at least 80% in the form of shares. Now, what options available? Option available. You can carry forward the loss indefinitely. Shares must be retained till the loss relief. There is a condition. If you want to utilize your losses, then shares must be retained until that loss relief. So if you have sold your shares before realizing the loss, then incorporation relief is not available. And another condition is your previous business must be continued. If that nature of business has been changed, then you cannot offset your previous business loss with this new company. Now, important thing, what are the options available? Your unincorporated business loss can be offset against the income that you are getting from that particular company, not the company's profit, against salary from that business. You are getting salary, you are getting any interest, you are getting any dividend, and the order first utilized against your employment income. This is the beneficial order, then against the saving income, and then lastly, if there is any dividend from that company, you can utilize from that dividend income. And remember, such losses cannot be offset with future profit of the company. So if the company is a profitable company, but that sole trader cannot get utilization of loss against the company's profit, but whatever is the salary, for example, the loss from the business was 40,000, and that business was incorporated as a company. And in the next year, he get a salary of, suppose, 20,000. So what he can do? He can utilize the 40,000 loss. Out of 40,000, 20,000 can be offset against salary. And in the next period, the remaining loss can be offset in the subsequent period. For example, the loss period, suppose, was 2021, and salary was in the period that is 22-23. 1 minute. Let me open my slide again. So I was just discussing about that, how you can offset your unincorporated business against that a new company, but you cannot offset your losses with the company's profit. Rather, you can offset your losses with the income that is being generated from the company, either in the form of salary or in the form of interest or in the form of dividend. And if all the income is available, then the beneficial order is first against employment income, then saving income, and then against the dividend income. Any question? So remember the condition. The 80% shares condition. The continuity of business condition. The holding of shares till the loss relief condition, and the condition that you can offset against income from company, not the profit from company. So you might face with a short question or a part question on this incorporation relief in any section B type question or section A type question.